Hey guys, just a quick message before this video starts. Just want to give a quick shout out to the Essential New Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. It is a book absolutely rammed with information regarding anything HGV related. It's everything that you need to know is in this book. Promise you, you won't regret it. Link is in the description down below if you are interested. The Essential New Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. Anyway, enjoy the video.
The noise it makes. It sounds like it's trying to die. Good morning everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Luke, thank you very much for joining me. I do appreciate it. How are you doing? How are you doing? We, as you might be able to tell, it says in the back, we are in a different truck today and for the entirety of this week. We're in a Renault T-High Sport Edition. The sporty range. It's the bright yellow one. It says Renault Sport over it. It's a lovely looking truck, I've got to admit. I do really, really like the look of this truck. There are negatives, there are positives. I'm sure I'll go through them at some point. But yeah, overall, it's a pretty decent truck, you know. Nice and modern. I like it. Anyway, today, we're loaded with... what are we loaded with? I forgot what we're loaded with. we've got crates of like slabs and stuff. We're going to County Building Supplies in Malvern. So it's just around the corner from the Three County Showground, actually, where Truck Fest is held. That is where we're going today. Now it is 8 o'clock. We were supposed to be there by now, but we've got held up in traffic. I timed it this morning so that I woke up early, got some fuel. So I filled it with fuel this morning as well. When I left the fuel station, my ETA was just before 8 o'clock, but we've been held up in traffic. So, and now we're still a good 20 minutes away. So, not good, but we'll get there in the end, and we'll get it off. It's been a bit of a bad week, to be honest with you. We've been held back all week, actually, and it's mainly to do with this truck. They were supposed to drop this truck off at 9 o'clock in the morning, Monday morning, which for us is quite late anyway. But by the time they got, they didn't even turn up to about 11 o'clock. So. Yeah, we're a good 2 hours behind schedule straight away, straight from the off, which meant I didn't get home Monday night, and then because I didn't get home Monday night, I couldn't get my load offloaded yesterday, so I didn't get home last night either. So it is Wednesday today, and we have actually been out in this truck since Monday, so I have really been using the truck to its full potential. I've been working in it during the day, sleeping in it during the evening, so yeah. We'll go through some of the stuff later. I've done a little cab tour in one of my last videos, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to go through some stuff again and just go through some of the menus or something. I don't know, we'll see. But yeah, we're about 20 minutes away from our job. We'll get there as soon as we can. And when we do get there, we'll get the curtains open, get offloaded, and find out what we're doing later. I don't know what I'm doing later, so we'll have to find out. And I'll show you the exterior of the truck as well, because honestly, it's a beautiful looking truck. It turns eyes. It definitely turns eyes. It's a bit dirty, but it does turn eyes. And I've got an air horn as well, so that's good. I'm not going to honk it, because it's very loud, and we're in close proximity to other people. Right, let's get crack-a-lacking. Let's get to our job. I will see you when we're there. So here we go then. I'll just show you a little bit of the truck on the outside. The sun is very bright. There we go. It is a beautiful looking truck. It's a little bit dirty, but yeah, it definitely turns heads, that's for damn sure. You're driving down the road and people go and have a look, probably because it says Renault Sport. I associate it with Formula One, personally. But yeah, it's a good looking truck. Okay, that's all my straps off. This is the load that we're getting taken off now. I think it was 28 pallets. 28 pallets, and they're three deep. I don't know if you could see that. But yeah, they're three deep.
28 pallets. All the straps are now off.
Side lockers. So there are actually two side lockers. You've got this one here, which opens up, and you've also got this one opens up as well. That's where I got all my straps. It's quite small. It's like I've got 13 straps and 13 ratchets in there, and that's pretty much taking up all the space. And then in there, it's not very big either, if I'm honest. I mean, combined, there's quite a bit of space, but because they're individual, so, I don't know, it's a bit awkward. It takes some getting used to for me anyway.
Okay, we are unloaded. Just gonna put paperwork away a sec. Excellent.
You will arrive at your destination at 10:59 a.m.
There we go, right, you start her up. Lift axle up as well. Axle lifting denied. Why? Ooh, I'm leveling up. That's why. Okay, now it's up. Right. This is one of the things I don't like about this truck. You've got to put it into drive to be able to put it in reverse. I'm just going to let them go first, actually, this forklift area. Okay, he's waiting, he's doing something. Okay, if he's just going to leave that there, then I will go back. I've got to do a spinny, but for some reason he's just left that there, so I was going to wait for him so he can go round, or go behind me, but he decided to stay there. So anyway, we've been specifically asked to do the spinny in this direction. Cheers, mate. See you later. Just want to clean this window a little bit. The sun's in it. Okay, I'm not getting out where that van is. Oh, I get to say thank you now by honking my horn. Let's clean that a bit more while we're waiting. Oh, get to honk the horn. I know, little things please me, I know. Right, before I went in, there was a learner driver. I say learner. He was being trained by somebody. And this corner did not look very nice for him. Just take it nice and wide, just got to mind the trailer coming around. Mind the tree, mind the house. There we go. I'll have automatic, please. Thank you. Oh, where's that nav taking me? Yeah, we'll go that way. I came in from the right, so I haven't been left. That car's waiting for me. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah, I come in from the other direction, so I don't know what this way is like, but we will find out. One thing's for sure, when the windows are up, it's so much quieter. There's a score coming up, but it's gone 9 o'clock, so it's half past 9. Ooh, it's getting a bit narrow down there. Should be alright. I've been to Malvern a few times. I've done a few different deliveries in different areas around here. So I have been around this area. It's just a case of like remembering. That's all. But we are on B Road, so I just want to be careful until we get to an A Road. There are a couple of nasty bends. Like through the high street. Not really designed for an Arctic at all. But never mind. Never mind. Yeah, so there's some things I like and there's some things I don't like about this truck. One of the things I don't like, you can't really see, but on the bunk, there's where you put your seatbelt into, like a seatbelt socket, presumably to hold the bunk up, because the bed does lift up. But there's nowhere visually to actually plug it into that I can see. But the issue is, it's because the plug socket, like the red socket where you put like a seatbelt into, it's so high up on the mattress that when you like sleep on the mattress, the mattress goes underneath the socket, if that makes sense. So the socket digs into you. So it's not very nice. I like to lean on the edge of the mattress. That's how I sleep. But I can't on this without getting a prick in the side. So yeah, that's one thing I don't like. But we'll follow that up with something I do like, and that's the engine brake. I like. It's got one and two switch, and then if you hold it, it does the third one, and you can leave it on. Someone's not forward planning. You can leave it on one or two, even when you're accelerating, and it won't work. And then as soon as you lay off the accelerator, it'll kick in automatically. Whereas with other trucks that I've driven, you have to use it as and when you want it, sort of thing. But yeah, no, with this one, you leave it on all the time, and it only works when you lay off the accelerator. Bradford's Building Supplies is down here. I've delivered down here loads of times. Thank you for giving me space. Yeah, Bradford's Building Supplies are down here. So yeah, I like the retarder. I don't like the bed where the red sockets are. The mattress itself isn't too bad. What else don't I like? The fridge. Thank you. It'd be nice if just the fridge opened or just the storage unit opened, but no. Everything you see, I don't know if you can see, but everything down there under the bunk opens up in one go. It takes up the whole of the floor space. So you can't have anything on the floor, bags or whatever, because the whole thing opens. If you want anything on the floor, it's got to be over by the passenger seat, otherwise you're not going to get that open without running over it or squashing it or something like that. So yeah, that could be designed a little bit better. And the noise it makes! It sounds like it's trying to die. What's wrong with just having a good old physical switch, says Bradford's. So yeah, I mean, but the fridge itself is obviously brilliant. It's a fridge, it's quite spacious inside the fridge. I believe it's a freezer as well, and the storage down there on the side of it is not too bad. I use it for my rubbish bin personally, so my bin isn't out. This is going to be quite tight. I've got to get that t-shirt made. Oh, that's tight. So yeah, I like the amount of lights there are in the cab. It really, really lights up at night. Like, it's not even nighttime. Inside, it's pure bright. It's like going into like a shop or something with their LED lights on full litness. So I like that. That's pretty cool. And obviously, there's a dimmer as well, so you can dim just how bright you want that switch to be, which is nice. What else do I like? I like the fact you've got the remote control. It's dangling over there. It's supposed to live on the other side, but I sleep on the passenger side. So I just dangled it over there. I won't be able to lower the bunk with it there, but I'll have to move it if I do lower the bunk, but I can't see me moving the bunk anyway. Oh, and I do like the fact that the top bunk, it comes down, and then you can just about see the split. The front half sort of like slips up, and then it can create like a little shelf across the whole back of the cab, so it gives you a lot of extra space that way. The only problem with that is when that bunk is down, it makes the cab feel a bit more claustrophobic. It makes the cab feel smaller, do you know what I mean? Not as spacious, so that's the only problem with that. Yeah, I mean, overall I do like the truck. There are, like I said, there's things I'd like and there's things I don't like. It'd be like that with any truck, do you know what I mean? I'm not one of these guys who are just going to go, oh, it's brilliant, it's amazing, it's the best truck ever. But yeah, it's quite quiet as well. I haven't even messed around to see if there's like a sport mode or comfort mode or economic mode. It's just in the mode it's in. The onboard, and I'm quite a techie person, but the onboard computer does take a little bit of getting used to. I haven't quite figured out yet how to switch between one menu and the other. Sometimes I go to control the menu down in the dash, but actually control the menu up there. Not quite sure why. That's the infotainment system. I don't like that. It's quite bulky. It's almost like it's a bit of an afterthought, if I'm honest. It could have been made a lot nicer. Maybe a curved thing. I don't know. It's just square, bulky. Just doesn't look nice. Doesn't look sporty at all, if I'm honest. That bit. But, you know, it's just an infotainment screen at the end of the day. But I don't use it. I can turn it off. It's off now. But the whole unit is still there. I don't know if you can quite see it in the camera or not, but the whole unit is there. So, yeah. Never mind. Right, anyway, we're going to crack on now. We're going to go to Lichfield. We're going to go get loaded with, I think it's 22, maybe 24 pallets of water bottles. And we're going to take it to my favourite place in the world, Iceland's in Swindon. It's good and it's bad. I mean, it's bad because it's Iceland's in Swindon and probably going to be there for ages. But it's good because it probably means I'm going home tonight. So, happy days. As I've said earlier, I've not been home since Monday. So it would be nice to go home, get some fresh clothes. Not that I've worn the same clothes, because I don't wear the same clothes every day, but it just so happens, and I hope I am home tonight, because it just so happens I only bought clothes for 2 days. I had to get so much stuff in this truck. I had 4 bags in total, and I don't want to bring a whole week's worth of clothes when I very rarely do more than 2 nights out in a row. It just so happens I've done 2 nights out in a row. So yeah, but yeah, we'll go home, get some change of clothes, have some hot food, and then I come back to work tomorrow with some cleaning products, because I want to clean the truck before I hand it back over, and also clean the outside a little bit, because it's very dirty. It was dirty when they gave it to me, but I wouldn't mind cleaning it up a little bit more so I can take some nice videography shots of it. Anyway, let's go. I'll see you when we are in Lichfield in about an hour and a half. See you in a bit. Okay, you join me an hour and a half later. Yeah, 1 hour, 32 minutes. My high-vis up there. I need to get my high-vis out for when I get to this place. Yeah, so we're just around the corner now, about a mile and a half away. We've been to this place before in the vlogs, haven't we? So getting loaded with water. Great big pallets of water. Yeah, my paperwork says booking in time is 3 o'clock. But I've just been speaking to my colleague, and he reckons, Andy, by the way, he reckons if they say 3 o'clock, it's probably 4 o'clock. So, yeah, I think we're definitely going to be early again. But we'll head straight there anyway, because me personally, I'd rather get there an hour early than an hour late. So, it might be 2 hours early. So I'll get there as early as I can. And if we've got to wait outside, which I expect we will, then we will. So, not a problem. All clear. All clear. So yeah, I quite like this truck. I'm coming round to it more and more. There are things though that I would want changing. There are, as I've said, the infotainment system is a bit rubbish, a bit bulky. It'd be nice if there was some sort of mat on the dash, which I'm sure you can get. Because you can't put anything on the dash because it just slides away, as it is. It's not grippy or anything like that, so I'm sure there'll be a mat of some sort you can get. I don't know if you can see, but that little hatch there stops the sun from getting in your eyes when it's right in the corner of the windscreen, because the blind doesn't actually cover the windscreen on the sides by a good sort of 3 inches. So that little flap there does the rest, which is very good. Looks cheaply done, like a bit of an afterthought, but better than nothing. Definitely better than nothing. Something else. I'm a little bit concerned with the fuel situation because we filled up with fuel this morning. Filled it right up. And how many hours driving have we done? Done about... Done about 3 hours driving. And I'm already on... I've already used a quarter of a tank. So, I don't know whether... I don't know. No idea. I'm only using about 10 miles per gallon, so it's not too bad, that 10 miles per gallon. On average. And I am pulling heavy loads as well. So, I mean, we're empty right now. But on average, we've got 10 miles an hour. No, sorry, 10 miles per gallon on average, with an average speed of 41 miles per hour. Right, how many of these trucks are going to go where we're going? That's the question. Anyone want to go karting? Right, the first truck's not going where I'm going, so that's good. That's one less to worry about. And he's not going. Excellente! None to worry about. Woo! Go down here. Yeah, it pulls well. So 510 brake horsepower this truck. So it definitely pulls well. Oh my god, that's busy. There's a lot of people in there. There's so many drivers queuing up as well. Look at everyone queuing up. Wow. So where are we going to park then, Luke? Can't park here, as I'm going to block the entrance for anyone else coming in. There's a space there. They're going to have to spin round. And reversing that space there. Wheels in reverse. So I'm just concentrating because it's a bit tight on the left side. I see. Yeah, we're good. Need to bring the trailer around a bit. It's not very straight, Luke. It's not very straight, Luke. Oh no, we're good. We're good. Got loads of room. We're in. There you go. Handbrake on. Oh, one thing I do like about this actually, the handbrake's on. If I want to move forward, I just put my foot on the accelerator and it starts moving. Or backwards, because we've still got it in reverse. So yeah, that's pretty cool. You haven't actually got to press the handbrake again. You just put your foot on the accelerator and it goes. So that's good. Right. Hi Viz. Oof. And face mask, we need here as well. Where's my face mask? There it is. There's my face mask. Happy days. Might be here a while. Right. That's the wrong way around. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, these are the water bottles. I mean, not all of them are going on, but some will be going on onto this trailer, and we'll whack some ratchet straps over there, over them all when he's put them all on. But as you can see, there's plenty of water here. But yeah, I think it's 22 pallets that go on, 12 either side. Maybe actually, you might put 13 on, so it'd be 26. So between 22 and 26 pallets, I'm not sure how many he's putting on. But once he starts putting them on the other side, I can throw some ratchets over and secure the load. But for now, we're just waiting. Just waiting for more to be put on. Hopefully we get this on and we can get offloaded quickly at Iceland. There's a car or something doing donuts over there. You can't see it, but you can hear it. Hear the wheel screeching. Right, let's get loaded. Right, paperwork is there. Take that off. I used to drive around with the Ivers on a lot, and now I'm just like, what's the point? I'm sure I will again sooner or later. But right now I'm just like, can't be bothered. Can't be bothered. Right, let's get the engine on. Just let him go. Right, so yeah, it's 10 to 1 now. In the afternoon. Let's turn that heating down. This is one thing I love about this Renault, I must admit. Handbrake is on, not moving. I've just put it in gear, and all I got to do is put my foot on the accelerator, and off we go. It releases the handbrake all by itself. Right, where are these trucks going? Yeah, I do like that about the Renault. You haven't got to release the handbrake. It's one less thing to worry about. Let's put my phone there a sec. There we go. Does matey boy know he's still got his hazards on? Still on, mate. Clear to the right, there is a car coming to the left. There we go. Thank you. Mind the sign, we're good to go. And he's turned his hazards off as well. Right, yeah, so we've got a 120 mile journey now to Iceland. My paperwork said 3 o'clock, our ETA is 20 past three. In theory, we will be let in. If we were told the delivery was 3 o'clock and it was actually 4 o'clock, which apparently can happen. They can tell you it's an hour earlier. Where are you going? Who's going left? Then if it is actually due for 4 o'clock, we should still be able to get in at 20 past three. So there is a good chance we will be let straight in, but yeah. Experience tells me not to be assuming I'm going to be let in, let's say. We could quite well be waiting outside, and even if we are let in, we still might be in there for 2 hours before we're even on a bay, and then 2 hours on a bay. You never know. So we will see. But anyway, let's crack on now to Swindon, and I'll see you when we're just about to roll up to the gates. Will we be let in, or will we be refused? See you in a bit. Okay, right, can you join me in Swindon? Don't know why I did it like that. Yeah, we're in Swindon, just around the corner from Iceland's. Will they let us in? That is the question. Hello, Mr. BMW, off you go. Will they let us in? We've got to get out this roundabout first. Mobile mechanic. That bike took a wide swing. Let me out. Oh, that bus is coming around. See, that car is indicating left before she actually come around here. Right, we can go. Yeah, sorry, a car just come around the corner and she was indicating left before she even come round, and it looked like she was coming off the next junction, and the car next to me actually pulled out, so yeah, not good. Now we're going to move over to the left. Happy days! Happy days! And we're going to turn left here. Right, Iceland's hello. There's no one queuing up to get in, so we'll be straight on the gate. But will they let us in? That is the question. The question that needs answering. My paperwork says 3 o'clock. If that's true, then we're on time, because the time is... My watch has died. Because the time is 20 past three. So if we are booked in for 3 o'clock, then we're fine. We reckon the booking time is 4 o'clock, and that we've been given an hour earlier time slot to make sure we get here on time. If that's the case, they should still let us in. We shall see. Hello mate, you alright?
Yeah, what's your reference number?
5-4. Harry and Sons. Luke. Yeah mate, I do. Number two. Alright mate. Out of interest, what time was that booked in for? 3 o'clock. Alright mate. Nice. Okay, into drive. And didn't even press the handbrake. Accelerator pedal. Okay, so it was booked in for 3 o'clock. That's nice. That's good. Fingers crossed then we get straight on the bay, because we're pretty much on time. Well, we're 20 minutes late, but pretty much time. Where's he going? Excellent. Right, anyway, I will see you in a little while. Like I said, 20 past three now. See what time we get out of here. Well, what's going on here then? Everyone's queuing up for the pumps. I'll go around this way. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, we're out of here. It might look like it's, well, I was going to say it might look like it's darker out. They probably don't, because they've got the internal lights on. It is darker out. It is later on in the day. It is just gone 20 past four. So we've only been here an hour. As soon as I got in, I went into the office and filled out some paperwork to say I was here, and they put me straight on a bay number 12. And then, yeah, undone my straps, reversed on the bay, half an hour later, give or take, we're done. Number two. Yeah, okay. Didn't even say okay, okay. Green light, let's go. Yeah, so yeah, it took about half an hour, so, to get the straps off, maybe just under, or then just over to get it all off. So yeah, we're near an hour. 1 hour, that's it. Only an hour. Aha! Happy days, happy days. So yeah, we're done for the day now. We are heading back to the yard. I need to go and get some AdBlue. Only got one bar left. So we'll fill up with AdBlue, ready for the morning. I don't actually know what we're doing in the morning. Still waiting to find out, but it doesn't matter, because that's not going to be on this video. So yeah, thank you very much for watching. Do appreciate it. Thanks for watching. Said that twice. Yeah, I really do like this truck. Really do. I might do another video on it, so we'll have two vlogs in the Reynolds Sport. Right, thanks for watching. Until next time, drive safe, stay safe, and I will see you. Bye bye. Like out.